The number 666 to the Great Fire of Rome. Early church historians spare no efforts in blaming Emperor Nero for the Great Fire of Rome. Nero, on the contrary, blamed the Christians for the fire and persecuted them. Who is the real culprit? Christians or Nero? A journey into the history of 1st century AD Rome, Judea and Greece opens up many channels of information, hitherto untold by historians. We can now locate Christ, Peter, Paul, Judas, John, and several biblical and historical personalities with new identities. A study of the Book of Revelations reveals stunning facts regarding the Great Fire of Rome, the evolution of Christianity from the Vedic culture of the Indus Valley Civilization, etc. Keywords: the Great Fire of Rome, Nero, Mithraism, Christianity, Bible, the Book of Revelation, Christ, Peter, Paul, John, Baptism, Mithridates, the Great Jewish-Roman War, Indus Valley Civilization, Nero's suicide. Nero committed suicide on the 11th of June 68 AD. Can we ever see through the high stories in ancient history? Will we ever come to know the real facts? Let us put the death of Nero on AD as a landmark of history. Let us go back 42 months in history and come forward. Let us go through the book of Acts, in the Bible. Suddenly we come across Stephen with a Greek connection, being stoned. Suddenly we see two men having visions. One is Peter, the other is Paul. The Christians change their names during baptism with a name listed in the book of the Lamb, Lamp, the Sun. Mithraism is the pagan name of early Christianity. Mitra, Sun, is Dharma, right, just. Cf. James, Shamas, the just, Sabah, religion, and Samaratfight, Dharma, Samara, is fight for a right cause of holy war. The Greeks and Jews fighting the Romans were waging a Dharma Samara. Revelation was written to show what must soon take place. Revelation 1:1, the author of the work, obviously, meticulously planned the events in the coming months and years. It was the strategic master plan, blueprint of things to come or to be executed in a span of time, covering several months and years, culminating in the overthrowing of Roman rule of Greece, Lonians, Yavanas, and Judea, Jerusalem, and establishing a new Greece, New Jerusalem. Revelation 21 cf. 21-666. The preparation for the assault on Rome was in full swing in the underground in the seven churches described in the book, as also Athens, Damascus, Galilee, and Jerusalem, when the book of Revelation was written. The Athenians revolted against Rome in 87 BC, but it was crushed by consul Lucius Camillus Sulla, who marched on Athens with a heavy hand, killing thousands of Athenians. The Jews revolted in 5 AD, and it was also crushed without any mercy. More than 2,000 Jews were hanged. It was led by Judas. The house of Judas is the house of Ushas, Dawn. It is the house of Judea, Sunrise, the birthplace of Mithra, the Holy Ghost, Vidya, Greek learning, Vid, knowledge, Veda, Dvi, Ravi, to Sun, Yuda, fight, and Vijaya, victory. Hence in Acts we see the choosing of the seven, including Stephen, who was later stoned for his utterances, like Jesus of Nazareth will destroy this place and change the customs Moses handed down, Acts 6:14. In Acts 7, we see Stephen narrating the entire past history of the Jews, and then come the stoning, Sila, of Stephen, Stepana, founding, which indicate laying the foundation stone of the new church, the past history serving to show the roots of the new church. Here Saul was present, giving approval to his death, that is approving the foundation stone laying of the new church. 7, Sapta, Devasade, was chosen as Sabah, church. Sa, God. Ba, light. Sa, Ba, Ta, warrior, is Hapta, Sapta, Sa, God, Pata, foot, Sabda, word, equals God, Tapasa, sun, itself. Immediately we see the Sabah persecuted and scattered like the Tower of Babel, Genesis 11, to denote daybreak and scattering of solar rays. Next we see Philip, Prava, shine, giving baptism as light as water. Next comes Saul's conversion at Damascus, Dama, Akasa, the sky, Saul is Tor, the bull. Saul is led to the house of Judas, Ushas, to open his eyes. Saul is the Buddha of Mithraism, Greek Christianity, after meeting Ananias, Snana, baptism, In Anavid Gnosis, in the house of Judas, Paul begins to preach Christianity. This house of Judas is the house of Jesus who founded Christianity. In fact, he is the Sabah, Basa, Light, Bada, Dawn, persecuted and scattered. The Great Fire of Rome broke out on the night of July 18, 64 AD, starting form the area of the Circus Maximus and gutting most of Rome in 9 days. Christian historians including Tacitus blamed Emperor Nero for the fire, Annales 15, 38-1. Most of the public were also of the same opinion. Nero was not in Rome but away in the coastal villa of Antium. It is said that he enjoyed the burning of Rome and was playing a song on the fall of Troy, a Greek fall, on his lyre. The Domus Aurea, Nero's majestic villa, was built after the fire. Nero was portrayed as a very cruel and sadistic tyrant who blamed the Christian church as those responsible for the fire and persecuted them mercilessly. Saint Peter and Saint Paul were arrested and martyred in this wake. So who is to blame for the fire? Nero or the Christians? Even if Nero was behind the fire, can he be so cruel as to bum his capital fully and play the lyre at the time? If he was not behind the fire, why such a meticulously plotted cruel propaganda to tarnish his image? War machines often engage in such tactics of Goebbelsian lies. Let us see how Nero played the lyre when Rome burned. The secret of the story lies in the Vedic name of the lyre, Veena. Veena denote the king. Veena, Veer, Vani, word, Pana, jar, Paala, Veer Dominus king, Veera, fire hero. In the Vedic language, the king is called Agni, fire. When the fire burnt Rome, Nero was the king of Rome. He being fire, burnt Rome, by go, bull, sun king, burning, burning, ruling it. A lyre is a lyre, hence Nero, cf. Narada with the lyre. Kakapi lied that the Christians started the fire, whereas he himself began the fire. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you again for more videos.